So in the last episode, we were able to map through our products and we displayed them on the UI. Now in this episode, we'll be making use of CSS to style our products. So the first thing that I'll do, I'll remove this products API that was auto imported here. We don't need it in this particular component. So I will remove that and save that file. And then I'll come to app.css. Earlier we added the styling for our navbar and also the not found component, and now let's add the styling for our home component. And what we can do, I can be able to split the screen using this icon like this, and then I can come to home right here and minimize that, and therefore with this display I'll be able to see the class names and select them on our CSS here. So right here I'll select our home container class. I'll say dot home hyphen container, just like that. And I'll add a padding top and bottom of 2 rem and left and right of 4 rem. And then right here, we can select the heading, which is new arrivals. And we can do it like this. I can say dot home hyphen container and then h2. And I'll set the font size for these to be 40px, and I'll also set a font weight for these to be 400, and then I'll set the text alignment to center, so we want to center that heading. Okay, with this I think the heading should be at the center, and there we go. Now let's style our products right here and display them side by side. So what I'll do, I'll select this products class right there. So right here I'll say dot products, and we will simply add a display of flex, and we'll also add justify content of space between, and also I'll say flex wrap to be wrap so that they can move to the next line in case the space is small. And I'll set some margin top, so margin hyphen top of about 2 rem, so that we can have some spacing between our heading here and the products, which is nice. So I will save that, and then when I come right here, now you can see our products are side by side, and now we can style individual product. So right here I'll select a product, and we'll add the stylings here. So this product is this particular class name, which is our product. So with this, we can give it a width of about 250px, and then we can give it a max width for responsiveness of 100%, and then I'll give it a height of 400px. And with this, let's see what we have. So not much have changed, and we need to style the images themselves so that they are not too big. So right here I'll select the image itself using dot product and then img, and we'll simply add a width right here of 80%, and then I'll add margin top so that we have some spacing between the image and the name of the product. So I'll say 1 rem, and then I'll add margin left and right. So I'll say margin left of outer and margin right of outer. And this will basically center our image inside our product card. So I'll save that, and there we go, much better. So they are nicely spaced, and yeah, I'm liking the progress. Let's go back to the product itself and add some more stylings. So what I'll do, I'll come back right here, and I want to equally distribute our different items inside our products. So what I want to do is to make this product a flex container, so that this will be an individual item, this will be an individual item, this will be an individual item, and this will be an item, and then we can distribute the space between them nicely. Okay, so in our product here I will add a display of flex, and then I will add a flex direction of column, and then I will add justify content to be space between. And this way, now we have equal spacing for our different flex items. And look at that, much way better. Okay, I will set some margin top and bottom. So I'll say margin top and bottom will be 1 rem, and I'll set left and right to be outer. And then I will add the padding to this of 1 rem, and then right here I will add a box shadow for our product so that it's more visible. And I'll say negative 5px, and then negative 5px, and then 10px, and the color will be RGBA, and I'll set this to be 255, and then I'll give it an opacity of 0.5. And then the second value for our box shadow will be 2px, and then this 5px, and the color will be RGBA, and I'll give this one to be 94, and then 104, and 121, and the opacity will be 0.3. So if I save this, this is a darker than this one, and we'll have a nice drop shadow for our product. And we can also add a border radius so that we don't have sharp corners. So I'll add a border radius of 15px. I will save that, and when I come back right here, I will refresh. The box shadow is not added. I'll inspect this. And let's select product, and it's not being added right here. Why? Invalid property value. Oh yeah, I see it. We shouldn't have commas right here. We shouldn't have commas for this. So this is 2px, 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 5px, and the color. So I'll save that, and hopefully it works. And there we go. So now we have a box shadow for our products. Now I want us to select each of these. I'll select this one, I'll select this one, and the button, and we'll style each one of them separately. Okay, so let's do that real quick. Right here I'll select the h3, I'll say product and then h3, and I'll add the font size of 25px and font weight of 400. That is the heading. Let's select our details class right here. So how we can do that is to select the product, and then we select dot details, and right here I will add a display of flex, and I'll say justify content to be space between, and also I'll align the items to the center. So that will create some spacing between them. Yeah, this is cool. So we have that description, and we have the price. We can select the price and make it bold. So I'll say dot product, and then dot details, and then dot price. And for the price, we'll simply increase its font size to 20px, and we'll add a font weight of 700, so it will be bold. I will save that, and that will do it. Let's just continue and select the button. So I'll say dot product, and then button, and then we can style a nice button for our product. So I'll give this a width of 100%. I'll give it a height of about 40px. I'll add a border radius to it so that we don't have sharp corners of 5px. let's give it some margin top. So I'll give margin top of 2 rem, and then we can change the font weight to 400. And finally right here, let's remove the border. So I'll say border none, and also I will remove the outline. So I'll say outline none, and we have an issue with border, the spelling is wrong. So border none, outline none, and I'll change the cursor to pointer, and then we need to give it a background color. Okay, so right here I'll give it a background color of hash 4B70E2, which is a bluish color. And when I save that, let's see what we have. So this is bold, and then we have a nice button. We can change the text color here to white, and also we can add some letter spacing. So right here I'll change the color to white, and I will set the letter spacing to about 1.15px. I will save that, and let's see. Good, now I think we have a nice button for our product. So this is all I will do in this video. We are done with styling this page. I think it looks nice and it's good to continue with. Now in the next episode, I think this is what now you have been waiting for, adding a product to cart. And that is what we are going to cover in the next episode. So that is it for this video, and I will see you in the next one.